when both ordinary people and scholars have thought about the legacy of the Manhattan Project, we've thought about the way in which physics and engineering were put to military use. We've thought about a destructive legacy, the arms race, the Cold War. Part of what I discovered was that atomic energy had just as much of a legacy in some of the fields that we think of as peaceable as it did in military uses. And specifically here, a lot of the advances in post-war biology and medicine that have been really taken for granted owe a lot to the materials and the policies that were part of the Cold War U.S. When the Manhattan Project resulted in the invention of nuclear reactors, many scientists working for the Manhattan Project understood that this would be a tremendous source, especially for the production of radioactive isotopes.
What are radioisotopes? They are merely unstable forms of elements giving off unseen particles or rays from the nuclei during the process of changing to stable form.
Initially, the hope was that radioisotopes could be used to cure cancer. So there was a great hope that perhaps cancer could be treated by finding kind of a magic bullet for every kind of cancer, a different kind of radioisotope that might localize to a tissue and kill a tumor from within the body. And there are some cancers that are susceptible to radioisotope treatment, although in the end it was more a replacement for radium as an external radiation source than a kind of a completely revolutionary new kind of treatment. So those uses were already known, and in addition, the discovery of stable isotopes had already led to tracer uses of isotopes. Tracer uses are when you replace one atom of a compound with a particular, you know, radio-labeled atom, so that you can follow that label through the ordinary chemical or biological processes that that compound goes through. And so radio tracing was very widely applicable to study biochemistry, physiology, endocrinology, eventually ecology, basically anything where a chemical compound is in motion. Radio tracing is a way to look at change over time and look at chemical transformations. There was still this great hope that radioisotopes were going to do great things for humankind. There was a story about the medical dividends of atomic energy that features a very striking color image. It shows a man who is in his pajamas, having stood up from a wheelchair, who is encircled in this kind of this halo of a mushroom cloud. And the suggestion is that he's been healed of whatever ailment had him in that wheelchair by the power of the atom. I think it captures better than any other single image the hopeful side. Certainly people understood that at high levels radiation was very dangerous, but it was over the course of the 1950s and 1960s that the hazards of low-level radiation came into clearer view. And that complicated the hope that radiation and radioisotopes could be beneficial for civilians, because certainly their use would expose some people to low levels of radioactivity. So then it became more of a calculation of when the risk was worth taking. And, you know, in most cases today, people feel like low-level risks associated with dental x-rays or tests in hospitals are worth it to get the benefits of radiation and radioisotopes. But people are more leery about the risks of radiation from nuclear power and other kinds of, you know, environmental contamination.